Mayor's office, mahalo for making the trip to be here with us today. It is so wonderful to welcome all of you to our first in-person State of the County address since 2019. We would have started earlier, but we wanted to be sure to accommodate the arrival of our neighbor island guests. And the surf was pretty good this morning. Saints, cemeteries. We certainly have been through a lot as a community over these past few years. While COVID-19 has dominated a good portion of our attention, our administration never lost sight of the core mission, going back to our first State of the County address. We will continue to support opportunities to rise by aligning with the principles of our home, our freedom, our connections, our mobility, our resources, our heart. And we do this by taking care of what we have while finding new ways to modernize our approach to services. These values will continue to be our compass as we start and finish this second term. But going back to surfing, it's no secret that I love to surf. Thank you to my wife for supporting healthy habits. But it's a delicate balance of strength and finesse. We must be acutely aware of surf as surfers of the conditions and surrounding environment at all times. Some days are calm and serene, and others are rough and unpredictable. And as much as we'd all love to surf that legendary perfect wave, our ultimate goal, of course, is just to stay above water. Inevitably, we will get knocked out. But all we can do is take a deep breath, stay calm, go for a ride, and hope that we don't get too beat up along the way. When I describe it in those terms, I gotta say surfing is a lot like being a mayor. Little bruised up, but it's been one heck of a ride. If we liken a mayor to being a surfer, then the county's budget is our surfboard. It is the vessel by which government is made possible. No one board is fit for every wave. It's uniquely crafted for specific conditions, but also designed to adapt and be flexible. Similarly, this year's budget is shaped for our current and unique environment as we navigate the shifting tides of a post-COVID economy. Our goal for this year's budget was to utilize our unique position to help shape our government, our island, our families, and in doing so, shape the future of the County of Kauai. Our approach to leadership remains the same since day one, in line with our long-standing RISE principles, but the board we use this year must be tailored and shaped to meet current conditions. With that, let's review our proposed fiscal year 24 budget. The goal of this year's budget is to continue shaping a strong foundation that future generations can stand on. We are doing this in line with our core values by one, paying down our debts while avoiding additional debt service or tax increases. We are ensuring that the bulk of our tax burden is paid by non-residents. And we are tackling necessary upgrades to our aging infrastructure. Large CIP projects that have been deferred for decades, all while delivering on the day-to-day county services our community expects. In partnership with our budget team, today we present an operating budget of $312 million and a capital improvement program of $90 million. While our budget policies have been consistent over the years, we did find ourselves in uncharted waters as far as revenue collection. With the strong support of our county council, Kauai was recently provided the opportunity to collect our own general excise and transient accommodations tax, alleviating the county's reliance on state funding. While this puts us in a position to steer our own path, economic uncertainty, rising inflation, and the sharp rise in property values created an environment we could not predict. Put simply, we did not foresee that our county would be in such a stable position as we emerged from the global crisis that was COVID-19. Our fiscal 24 budget reflects proposed total revenues of $320.2 million. This includes $32.4 million in general excise tax revenue, $23 million in transit accommodations tax, and $219.8 million in real property tax revenue. While the county finds itself in a positive position, we recognize the burden of the ever-increasing cost of living is on our residents. That is why we are proposing 10% decrease to the residential and homestead property tax rates. Further, with the passage of Ordinance 1146, we anticipate issuing roughly $5 million in tax credits to homeowners who qualify for reclassification from residential investor to residential. It is also worth noting that transient and non-residents contribute over 63% of our general fund revenues. In other words, the lion's share of our tax burden sits on the shoulders of our visitors and not on the backs of our people. While we know we cannot solve all our island's issues, our operating budget aims to meet the community's expectations with a focus on infrastructure. A significant portion of our operating budget will be used to decrease the county's debt and reduce the liabilities that our children must pay. Of the $180.4 million in our general fund, roughly 77% is dedicated to employee salary and benefits, including recent increases due to collective bargaining agreements. This leaves little more than 20% of our general fund to dedicate to our county's core functions and services. Additionally, we are dedicating nearly $13 million to pay off our state DIRF loan for our Limahola housing project. Investing this money now saves the county millions in interest payments over the life of the loan and frees up our housing development fund to be used as intended to develop affordable housing. We're also paying down our approved post-employment benefits, ensuring that our retirees receive their well-deserved health care. And lastly, we are funding the full cost of all new vehicle and equipment purchases, saving over $1 million in interest costs by avoiding a lease-to-own program. Our GET fund will dedicate $15.5 million towards road repaving, with another $18.5 million in CIP related road costs to help us improve roads, including Kolo, Kilauea, Kauaihao, and Puhi roads, and the addition of sidewalks to Moy Road. GET funds will also help to improve our aging culverts and bridges island-wide, and will fund the planning of a shared use path from Waimea to Kekaha, finally connecting our west side communities. This budget also continues to leverage federal funds to offset the cost of our larger infrastructure projects and the restoration of wetlands within Waimea 400. Kauai was also recently awarded $24.8 million for the highly competitive federal raise grant for our Poipu Road Safety and Mobility Project. Mahalo to our congressional delegation for your continued support of these critical initiatives. Over 90% of the additional CID appropriation will be dedicated to deferred maintenance, solid waste, and wastewater projects as we make good on our promise to prioritize infrastructure. We are dedicating over $10 million to repair the roof of the Kauai War Memorial Convention Hall and replace the HVAC system at our Kauai Police Department headquarters. We are matching the state's appropriation of $6.5 million for a total of $13 million in upgrades to the Dina Stadium as the main stage. As the main stage for sporting events on Kauai, it is high time our Kiki get the facility they deserve, complete with improved lighting, replacement of our track, and converting the field to artificial turf, finally giving our Kiki a level playing field to compete and perhaps dominate with the rest of the state. These are only the highlights of our larger funds and projects, but our proposed budget looks to shape the future of our island through a variety of initiatives. As always, that starts by looking within to evaluate our government operations. If we look at the shape of the surfboard, we can easily recognize how the board has changed over time as both shapers and surfers adapted to changing technology and techniques. Government is typically slow to adapt, but we vowed to change the culture when we took office. We were eager to ride the wave of modernization to create efficiencies in our workplace by providing our associates the tools and equipment to deliver excellent customer service. We are pleased to report that our new Workday HR management system is now live, offering a streamlined electronic process for payroll and personnel records. The next phase will focus on recruitment and training. Big mahalo to our Workday team and to all our associates for bringing this program to life. Our transportation agency has dropped into the 21st century with its Kauai Bus Tracker app, now offering real-time notification of bus locations and schedules, paratransit requests, and more. This year, we are implementing an electronic fare system no longer requiring cash payments or paper passes. Our phased implementation of the land information management system helps departments share information while offering improved service to the public. LIMS allowed for the recently launched Road Resurfacing and Bridge online status map, which we creatively named Really Cool Maps, allowing the public to easily track road projects on our website. God, can you make it rain harder? We are also upgrading outdated equipment. Our police and fire departments will begin phasing in new radio equipment that tie into the Federal FirstNet Public Safety Broadband. Oh no, you better go get that one over there. Go get that one. You okay, mama? You sure? Your hair is so beautiful. I got this.
Got it.
Yeah, thank you. These radios will provide better security and coverage, thereby improving response and safety for our first responders. And a big mahalo to to our Kauai Emergency Management Agency for assisting this effort. This budget also seeks to add critical new positions as we expand and improve programs to adequately serve our growing population and changing needs. We are requesting a new position under our Parks Department to help maintain the recently renovated Kauai Veterans Cemetery, hallowed ground. A new liquor licensing clerk will assist all of our liquor licensees, reducing delays in applications. We also propose an additional deputy county attorney to oversee our risk management program, minimizing risks to the county property, employees, and our people. Finally, increased complexity in the real property tax code and expansion of tax relief programs has resulted in the need for a real property position to help maintain adequate service to our customers. Speaking of customer service, on our first day in office, we promised to eliminate long lines at our DMV. We are proud to say that with the addition of an online reservation system, Kupuna Hour, and island-wide registration kiosks, we have made good on that promise, but we are not done. Last week, we broke ground on our Kapa'a satellite DMV, and once complete, it will offer the same over-the-counter services as our Lihue location, and we are dedicating 6 new positions to this new facility. Mahalo to all of our DMV team members for their willingness to adapt and create a better customer experience. We have also significantly increased our training and development budget, because here at the County of Kauai, we want to look beyond the standard education requirement for government jobs and enhance career paths for those with skills and ambition, because as important as it is, a college degree is not and should not be the sole indicator of talent. As our government adapts to our growing population, so must our community and our island. If there's one thing that frustrates a surfer, it's a crowded lineup. And let's face it, at times, Kauai can feel crowded. While the county doesn't control population or visitor arrivals, we can help to manage the way people move, how they build, and where they stay. Through the determination of our planning department, we are seeing the lowest rate of illegal vacation rental operations in over a decade, ensuring that our visitors stay in designated visitor destination areas. We are also piloting a visitor-managed parking program as we work to implement a paid parking system for visitors who park at Poipu, Lindy, or Black Pod Beach Parks. We thank our county council for their support of this pilot as we work to ensure that our visitors pay their fair share for the valuable resources they require. And for visitors open to alternative modes of transportation, our Office of Economic Development is working to develop a mobility hub in Kapa'a. The vision is to have a network across the island that provides an array of transportation services in an effort to reduce traffic congestion and connect people more sustainably. There are many elements to our destination management action plan that we are working to implement. We are so grateful for our partners, Sue Kanoho at the Kauai Visitors Bureau, for leading this effort, and the Hawaii Tourism Authority for recognizing that our visitor industry must strike the right balance between economic opportunity and quality of life for our people. Where did I just walk away? What did I just say? Oh, see, Kalina. On that note, our housing agency, led by Adam Reverse and his team, along with the private developer partners, is on track to break ground on 400 new affordable housing units in 2023. That's a record. That is a record for Kauai. This will have an economic value of roughly $260 million of job creation and money flowing to our local economy. But more important than generating money and jobs is the fact that we're building roots over the heads of 400 local families. And we thank the state for allocating the largest amount of funding ever provided to Kauai, and mahalo again to our county council for the courage to walk alongside us in this effort. Where and how we build communities is critical to shaping our island. Our planning department is preparing the East Kauai Community and Circulation Plan to help develop a long-range land use and transportation plan appropriate for our east side. In Waimea, we'll begin pre-development work on 32 acres for affordable housing on our Waimea 400 parcel. We are also entering phase two of developing Kauai's climate adaptation plan as we evaluate the threat of climate change to our infrastructure and establish recommendations to build resilience. But we didn't wait for a completed plan before we took action. We worked with our county council to make history as Kauai became one of the first counties in the nation to regulate new construction based on sea level rise projections. Solid waste management is the most significant issue facing our island right now. As our landfill nears capacity, we are piloting a construction and demolition debris diversion program as we continue to study more sustainable alternatives to dumping our waste. In the meantime, we're expanding the life of our current landfill while we work to site a new one, and we thank our partners at PMRF. Thank you very much, Captain. Our avid community in Kekapa and the state ABC for helping us to navigate this monumental task. We also extend our sincere appreciation to the good people of Kekaha, and as a mahalo for your partnership, we have increased funding to the Kekaha Host Community Benefits Program. But more important than any infrastructure project is the safety of our residents and visitors. Kauai has reported 5 drownings in the past 5 months. This is a trend that cannot continue. We are proposing 12 additional ocean safety officers to commence a dawn to dusk program to provide expanded hours and coverage. With extended hours for lifeguard towers and enhanced roving speed patrols, we can accomplish quicker response times for ocean rescues because every minute counts when attempting to save a life.
Saving lives
and supporting families sits at the core of what we do as a county, and our budget commits to caring for our families from Keiki to Kupuna. We are pleased that Kauai Police Department has revitalized the Kauai Police Activities League with a dedicated space at the Philippine Cultural Center, along with upgrades planned in Hanapepe and Kapaha. KPD will also purchase new equipment to rebuild a robust K-PAL program with various activities to keep our youth engaged, and a big mahalo to our volunteer officers and coaches who dedicate their time to our KPD. Part of steering our youth in the right direction is providing adequate adolescent drug prevention and mental health support. While these services are typically not in the county's wheelhouse, they cannot be ignored in part. They cannot be ignored any longer. In partnership with our prosecuting attorney's office and our Life Choices coordinator, we are proposing to invest $1 million for the grant program to support our nonprofit partners in the fields of drug treatment and mental health. Thank you very much, Cheryl Tobin. We thank all those that came before us. Mayor Carvalho, Mayor Baptiste, all the people that have come before. We thank Grove Farm for its leadership in bringing a treatment center to our island, and look forward to the opening of the Kaulu Ikopono Academy this year. We thank our county council for your guidance in bringing this shared vision to life. Helping our residents through tough times can come with its challenges, particularly as we work together to support our houseless population. The proposed assistant homeless coordinator position will help provide a more tailored outreach program in matching our houseless residents with available resources. In addition, we look forward to building a second Kealaula housing project at Limaola and expanding the original Kealaula in Lihue in partnership with the state. This model of supportive housing has helped dozens of families successfully transition into permanent housing. Caring for our families means caring for our kupuna. With continued ARPA funding, our Agency on Elderly Affairs continues to deliver meals and produce boxes for our kupuna in need of food security. The produce delivery program began during COVID and not only helps to feed our kupuna, but supports our local farmers as well. We thank our federal, state, and nonprofit partners for helping us to continue this much needed program. Lastly, we support Governor Green and Lieutenant Governor Luke in their effort to provide universal access to preschool for our people. We have an opportunity to do that right here at the old Big Safe Space, which has sat vacant and unused for the past 10 years. We're going to redesign and renovate the space to offer infant to toddler care and other youth-based programs. On-site childcare has been a long-standing request of our state, our county associates, our community, and we thank our county council for approving the ARPA funds to help our working parents return to work. The need for added support in the areas of mental health, houselessness, and early learning are not unique to Kauai and cannot be solved by government alone. These are monumental community issues that require a whole community, a whole statewide approach to make a difference. That is why I'm so humbled to be a part of this community and to have your partnership and the partnership of our fellow counties as we work together to shape a better future for the next generation. There's something about surfing that's also incredibly humbling. To be but a speck in the middle of an expansive, magnificent ocean. And if everything aligns perfectly for a surfer, for a brief moment in time, we can ride on water. It's a feeling that cannot be described in words, and one that surfers try to replicate over and over and over again. It's that same feeling I have now and every day that I have the honor of being your mayor. It's in the work that we do, in the families we raise, in the community we build, it's in the people, in the people we serve. We have but a brief moment in time to make a difference, to ride on water, and on behalf of our team, we have our promise that we will continue to adapt, to evolve, to improve, to fight for our people in this community that we love. And with your partnership, we will shape the future of Kauai, one that makes the next generation proud, and we will raise our children. We'll raise our children to believe that if we can ride on water, we can do anything. And do it over and over again. Now, surfing is a journey. Life is a journey. Being a mayor is a journey. Being a dad is a journey. Every single one of us is on a journey. And whether you know it or not, we're on this journey together. And the most important thing about this journey is not just the experience, not the destination, but it's the people you get to share that journey with. My family and I are so blessed to have so many wonderful people that have been on this journey with us. Some folks have been there from the very beginning of time. Some people have joined us a little later on our path. Some people are taking a momentary break from this journey. And wherever you are, you will always be a part of our life. For one special journeyman, his name is Mike. I owe you so much for believing in this, for believing in me, for committing everything that you had to this beautiful island that you're not even from. You went to Punahou, but I will tell you that you are their pride and joy, but you're the pride and joy of Kauai. And this journey of brotherhood never ends. You are my brother. Give them a round of applause. It's been one heck of a ride so far, bruises and all, but we are proud of the strong state of our county, and we look forward to what's to come. Thank you so much for allowing us this opportunity to be here today. God bless and aloha. We love you all. Thank you very much.
And this is only rain, so don't worry. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. And this is only rain, so don't worry. Okay, so before we end, though, we can have a seat for that special presentation by Kumulin Ala. for about 30, and one from Mokuhanas, which is three, so we actually, two Mokuhanas.
Oh, I see.
And also we play some music from Kauai Mokuhana or Lena Ala. I've got a hand for Kumu Lena Ala.
Mahalo nui, kaleo. Mahalo nui. Mahalo Mayor and everyone for having us here today. And we want to close with this very special hula that we've been working on just for today. You spoke about surfing, correct? Yes. So, there is a hula, there is a mele, the area. It's not on Kauai, it takes us to Hawaii Island, but I thought, not two birds with one stone. We'll talk about surfing, but we'll also honor King Kalakaua. In a couple of weeks, we leave for Merry Monarch Festival. So I thought, hey, let's honor both, right? Our mayor, our king, and our King Kalakaua. You know, for those of you that may be familiar with Ka'ea, there is a hidden meaning in Ka'ea, but we'll just stick to the basics, which talks about surfing. And life is all about balance, right? And the beauty that surrounds us. So enjoy as my ladies Breeze and Jaden share with you Ka'ea with Mr. Bronson Iwobi.
I am all of you. I am the king of the town.
Okay, with that, mahalo very much again for coming. I appreciate you both second for sticking out with us, picking it out with us in the ring. Although I know when they do, but that's okay. Where's my umbrella? I'm going. So with that, mahalo, thank you for coming. I'm gonna come again, mahalo Louie. I'm going to refresh this in the back and coffee. So with that, we'll say, and thank you for coming. Again, go home. Because good drive. Mahalo.
Thank you.